Baltimore won the toss and went green out. LA then went green out themselves, but their punt coverage team said, hey, like, what if we allowed a game-losing punt return touchdown, but, like, as a joke? And they did, as Tylan Wallace returned the kick 76 yards to give Baltimore the 37-31 win. Cleveland versus Jacksonville. I just want to say thank God that Trevor Lawrence is still alive after nearly dying from his ankle injury last week. Based on his performance in this game, however, I think the Jaguars probably should have rested. Big Dick Joe Flacco was in the house, though, and he helped Cleveland put up a 14-0 early lead with two touchdown passes. He also helped set up Jacksonville's first touchdown with a terrible interception, which made it 14-7 at halftime. The Jaguars fumble set up a 22-yard touchdown drive for Cleveland to start the third.
Then Flacco
fumble set up a 25-yard Jacksonville touchdown drive to make it 21-14 Cleveland entering the fourth. Lawrence threw his third and final interception of the game on a manly deep throw to Pete Rose, Calvin Ridley. Flacco then threw his third touchdown to put Cleveland back up 14. Lawrence responded with a touchdown drive to make it 28-21, and even got the ball back down 7 with 4:24 left, but turned it over on downs. Cleveland added a field goal to go up 10, then T. Law led another touchdown drive to make it 31-27 with a minute 33 left, but the onside kick failed, sending Jacksonville to Loserville for the second straight week. Cleveland now sits at 8-5, thanks to Sean Weinstein's leadership. Minnesota versus Vegas. This game ended with a 3-0 score. That's right, 3-0. Well, I'm sure there's a reason. The weather must have been terrible. Actually, it was cold in a dome. Well, maybe both teams needed to use position players as quarterbacks. Well, actually, no, both teams had their same starting quarterbacks as last week. You mean to tell me that this game ended with a score of 3-0 because these teams were just that ass? Good Lord, I mean, barf bag. 23 combined possessions ended with 3 points, which came in Minnesota kicked a field goal with 2 minutes left after benching Josh Dobbs, rocket scientist, by the way. AOC, damn. No, not that one, but for all intents and purposes, it might as well have been her. She couldn't have done any worse. Then threw a game-losing interception for Vegas. I want you to take a moment and please pray for all the children who were exposed to this abomination of a game. They're going to have PTSD for the rest of their lives. San Fran versus Seattle. With Drew Locke at quarterback for the Sea Pigeons, it's a wonder the 49ers didn't win this game by 50. They were even trailing 10-7 after the first quarter before Brock Purdy found fat ass Debo Samuel with a great touchdown pass to throw 14-10. Seattle's offense predictably slowed down, and San Fran steadily expanded their lead to 11 in the third following another Samuel touchdown. But Locke actually showed signs of life, leading a quick touchdown drive to cut it to 5 entering the fourth. But then Kyle Shanahan threw a 44-yard touchdown pass to George Kittle to cut the lead back up to 20-16 with 14 minutes left. Locke threw an interception, then San Fran fumbled. The teams exchanged punts, and then Locke threw another interception before San Fran ran out the clock to improve to the one seed. Denver versus the Chargers. Boring as hell like most Broncos games, this was never close at any point. Denver was up 7-0 after one, then they went up 10-0 at halftime, and then they were up 17-0 after three. The big takeaway from this game is that Justin Herbert fractured a finger, or he fucked up his hand somehow, on his throwing hand, and considering the Chargers are now 5-8 and out of the playoff picture, there's no reason to really play him the rest of the way. Just fire Brandon Staley, hire Bill Belichick, and reset for next year. Believe me, Chargers fans, all 14 of you, Easton Stick is not going to lead any miracles. Anyway, Denver won 24-7 to improve to 7-6 following their dreadful start. Props to them, but nobody outside of the marijuana-condoning state of Colorado wants to see them make a deep playoff run since they're boring as hell. Buffalo versus Kansas City. One of the best rivalries in the NFL.
Oh, come on.
Half-decade added another entertaining chapter to its story with this one. KC and Mahomes once again started the game like crap, throwing an interception, not scoring any points, and falling behind 14-0 before turning a Josh Allen interception into a touchdown to make it 14-7 at halftime. Buffalo pumped it up to 17-7 before KC trimmed it right back to 17-14. Kansas City's next drive saw them fumble the ball away, which happens every game for them. It's actually kind of scary. But Buffalo couldn't take advantage of it, and KC eventually tied the game at 17 with 11:33 left. The teams exchanged punts before Allen led a long field goal drive to put Buffalo up 3 with a minute 54 left. Mahomes was moving the ball before he and Travis Kelce created what looked like an incredible go-ahead touchdown lateral to Kadarius Toney, but the dipshit Toney lined up offsides to negate the play. Mahomes then threw three straight completions to seal the loss for his rage from the Toney offsides, and his years of pent-up PTSD from D. Ford lining up offsides got the best of him. Mahomes' career stats have tanked badly this year. I'm grateful for the MBS drop as an Eagles fan, but if the Eagles can't win at all, I want Mahomes to win to pass Brady. Maybe Mahomes is in his post-1987 Dan Marino phase now. I do know his receivers are doing everything they can to make sure he does not pass Brady in rings. As for Buffalo, what an excellent coordinated effort on foreign soil. foil by Sean McDermott.
Yes, sir. It's a much needed one, too.
Dallas versus Philly. All right, all right. Enjoy the moment now, Eagles haters. I'm not making any excuses. Dallas outplayed us, and we had three terrible fumbles that killed premium scoring drives. You all watched the game. You don't need me to recap it, you sadistic bastards. It looked like it could potentially be interesting after Jalen Carter's fumble return touchdown in the third, but Philly just could not get out of their own way. We're still 10-3 and can win the NFC East.
I need a fucking breakout here, man.
Many people are saying that they've never seen such bravery from NFL fans sticking with his team the way I am right now, despite back-to-back blowout losses. Let me tell you how it's going to go, okay? Dak is going to finish his MVP runner-up with Brock Purdy, and the Cowboys will claim out for the NFC Championship game as usual, and nobody will remember this game when the Eagles and 49ers meet in the NFC Championship game. I trust Jalen Hurts. I do not trust this Eagles defense. Now, excuse me while I go back to binge-watching Glee to help me forget about the last two games.
Glee.
Giants versus Packers. Hey, did you know that Tommy DeVito is Italian? Like, really Italian? This game started off as boring as you'd expect. There were a bunch of punts and missed field goal, but it turned out to be pretty entertaining, actually. Packers struck first with a touchdown run before Saquon Barkley answered back with a touchdown run of his own to tie it. Jordan Love committed turnovers on back-to-back drives, but the Giants sucked, so they didn't score any points off of them, and the Packers took a 10-7 lead into halftime. Green Bay muffed a punt, which set up Barkley's second touchdown run of the game, to go 14-10. In the interest of fairness, the Giants then muffed a punt themselves, but the Packers only got a field goal. DeVito, who may or may not have murdered Tony Soprano, then threw a nice touchdown to put the Giants up 21-13. Packers missed a field goal, but eventually cut it to 5 anyway with 5:30 left in the game. Barkley then had one of the most objectively hilarious fumbles in NFL history, which the Packers capitalized on with a touchdown pass, but a failed two-point conversion, to go up 22-21 with 1:33 left. DeVito then said, "Hey, I'm walking in," to defenders and got the Giants into position for the game-winning field goal as time expired, which fat Randy Bullock nailed to give the Giants an improbable 24-22 win. Great job, Green Bay, you assholes. Tennessee versus Miami. For some reason, there was a Monday Night Football doubleheader this week with both games being played at the same time, but I don't mind because I'm used to watching my wife take two things at once. Anyway, this is another game that started out boring but ended up being entertaining. Tua turned the ball over, fumbled deep in Tennessee territory, but Billy Levis gave it right back with a pick six. Some time passed, then the Titans tied the game following a Derrick Henry touchdown run. Miami had a field goal block, and Tennessee eventually went up 10-7 at halftime on a 28-yard field goal. A soccer match broke out in the second half. Snore. Miami kicked a field goal to tie it at 10, then Tennessee kicked a field goal to go up 13-10, then Miami kicked another field goal to tie it back at 13. Insert Karl Malone joke here. More punts were had before the Titans muffed a punt. Good lord, these assholes have one job as punt returners, and it's to not fumble, and they can't fucking do it. This
oh my god! I gotta get Pickens out of this, because he fucking... He just dominates.
Which again set up another short Miami touchdown to give the Dolphins.
Oh, I would have fucking lost it if he caught it.
13 lead with 4:34 left. Levis then led a long touchdown drive, capped off with a score to DeAndre Hopkins, who left his fingerprints all over this game like it was a hotel room wall, and a 2-point conversion to make it 27-21. Tennessee got the ball back again and quickly scored again on a fishtail Henry touchdown run to go up 28-27 with 2 minutes left. Tua would have a golden chance to be the hero, but he completely shit himself as he was sacked on fourth down to seal the loss. The Dolphins were so dead.
Still got gold. Let me get the superstar.
Team Barry Awards, the Offensive Player of the Week. It was a pretty weak week, so I kind of just went with Debo Samuel again by Paul. 149 yards receiving, a touchdown, also had a touchdown run. Not great, but it was okay. The Defensive Player of the Week, Harold Andrew III, Tennessee, had 3 sacks, 5 quarterback hits in Tennessee's miraculous win. My biggest loser of the week specifically is Kadarius Toney for having a drop, and obviously lining up offsides and then the game-winning touchdown. But more so the Chiefs, because now they're 8-5, and every year they have with Mahomes that goes by where they don't win a Super Bowl will feel like a massive missed opportunity. If the Eagles can't win, I want Mahomes to win because I'm sick and tired of Tom Brady being the goat to the masses. My Tom Brady checkdown of the week goes to Jake Browning for this unreal touchdown throw early on in Cincy's game. This is what a generational talent looks like. This is how you win 7 Super Bowls, folks. Now that all that stupid, silly football stuff is over, it's time to get to the real part of this video that you've all been waiting for. Puppy time, don't you dare.
flipped that out on the spot.
On the spot.
It was like a perfect spiral.
Dude.
Like, how did you go from having it tucked to throwing a perfect spiral that fast?
At the confluence of the three rivers, the Ohio, the Allegheny, and the Monongahela, we are here at Pittsburgh's Acrisure Stadium. Today, it's a week 9 matchup.
There won't be a lot of commentary today. I'm
exhausted.
I didn't get over to the guy that I wanted. That's not the start we can have.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Here comes a return from the middle of the end zone.
Dude, that is golfer. Table, go ahead, Andrews. Thank you. Oh, do not get me holding on that. Dude, that's so whack. That ball's literally done out of there. That's insane. That's insane. That's insane that I didn't get that passing today. That lag was a little shaky. I like playing like it though.
Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone.
My case is fun to play.
Hmm.
What a user. What a user. Dog. He's gonna fumble sooner or later. Bring it back. Bring it back. I wouldn't have accepted it if he didn't accept that one earlier. Because play's already over. Damn, I knew that was the play. I knew that was coming. I knew it was coming, man. Good play, McDonald. Oh man, blitz was there, the blitz was there. Take you three. This doesn't have the right route. That had the fullback in there. I realized as I called the play, and I don't want that. Here's the cover six. Which this should be. Man, I hate that. Yep, there it is. I told you. I tell you?
Right now they're ranked number 29 in the NFL against the pass, so fourth from the bottom, Charles.
Take those rankings, throw them right out the window, because this is what you prepare for, this is what you practice for, this is what you think about.
What did I tell you? Bro, where's my throw animation? He just didn't throw it. You know what's coming.
We gotta fall forward there, man.
I know he was going to come out with that 5-2 blitz. Maybe not the blitz, but the 5-2. He likes that on the goal line. What's up, Kylo? I've seen this earlier. I got bailed. Oh, wow. I know YK's ticked about that one. I thought it would put me over the top. Oh, I'm heated. He's challenging it. I know he is. Yeah, I was gonna say.
Yeah.
Bro, that's crazy. Drop back's one thing, though. Going back with the car. ARB. We gotta make that throw. We gotta make that throw. We gotta make that throw. Let's go. Look at that. Bro, he's soft. I hate this running back. Like, you should be running people over, dog. Four plays, 75. You love to see it. You can't let off the gas with Blackett, because he, as you've seen twice already, he's a threat. This offense is a threat to score at any fucking time. He hasn't tested it, so we'll take that off. Throw that on. Is he hurt? No.
The Raven offense set in the line for this next drive. And you know, there's certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but
the Heat's there, man. Fucking, he drops so far back that the fucking glitch, it delays the time to get there. Wow, what an insane run by a tiny bag. There it is. Derek, god damn it, man. I almost played that hook, too. Man, you don't tackle him, you give him the... I hate that animation. I hate the animation, man. Take that out of the game right there. Like, you're gonna bump him, and then they just both come to a stop, and they're like, oh, we're still up. Man, I'm not gonna get to return one at all.
offense here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching their heads.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now, but let's face it.
I got streaks too, big dog. Get that tiny man out of here. That shit got deactivated off that too. It's whack as fuck. Let's go, Najee. Let's go. Good ball back. Good ball back. Let's go. Ah! Take out my kicker! We accepting that. That's the fucking user, dog. Take it out, pussy. Dog! The fucking heat's there too! He drops back so far that the heat doesn't get there in time. It's so fucking annoying. Five for 258. Come on.
So right back to square one, tied at 28 as he kicks it away.
I'm forced to play man because of our man zone requirement. You lost it up and you click on.
Field if they so choose. On first and
dog! Who's the DPI? He went through my receiver! What more can I do on that play? Tell me. Dog, you was on a QB spy. Dog, you was on a QB spy and ran in there like a dumbass. Service on match. Hurry up. Yep. Did he just audible to the same play? Inside leverage. Inside leverage. Where the fuck's the inside leverage? You just didn't react. But come on. Come on, man. That's so terrible. It's terrible, bro. Dog, why'd I get that, like, cut animation? I don't like that. I didn't like that. I got, like, a weird cut animation on that. I didn't want to run out of bounds. But I did. Dude, that's whack! Get that out of here! No, if you ain't gonna tackle, bro, don't be diving from 10 yards out. If you're gonna tackle, tackle. If you're gonna tackle, tackle, bro. That before half is what's going to cost me the game. That play before half cost me this game. Yep, there's that. The ball's not there yet, and I'm getting tackled, man. He wishes it had been 7-on-7 in practice, or maybe even routes versus air, because that's a completion he makes, what, 9.9 times out of 10? Just missed it. Dude, I fucking... fucking... We fucking ID'd him and y'all ignored him! That's so annoying, bro. Dude, how we ID him and y'all ignore the motherfucker? Like we couldn't call where his fucking user was. God fucking damn, man. Where the fuck's the middle of the field safety? I did not audible to a cover fucking four. That should be Tyreek deactivated, no? Wow. This game, I can't put, that mistake before half cost me this game. I already know. Yo! Two superstar corners right there. Neither one of y'all get a fucking breakup. Y'all got abilities for that shit. What is it? Why can't... Come on. You know that's whack, man. Come on. I'm trying to shift the defense around and snap, so... Yep, that mistake before half cost me the game. That's tough.
Charles, a very uninspired effort. The last time we saw them out there was a quick three and out, and they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get stopped so soundly during the series, but it would be even worse.
Dog, what happened? My man's literally just started running backwards instead of going on his route. Nobody else was open.
Second down, here's Pickett. He's got this to Pickens. And now they're in there.
can't. Why are we throwing it to the fans? You're killing me, man. We throwing the ball to the fans, man. Because I can't throw a whole shot this fucking Madden. Cover two, bro. That's a whole shot.
Crazy fashion.
The whole shot. You can't throw them this Madden.
Another low scoring game for us, man. I think our
Percy Butler, I think that is. Did not play onto the inside route at all. Instead is shading outside, cheating outside the entire way. In the cover two. Look at it. This is a fucking good option. Told y'all. Run at the sideline. Break the pursuits. Oh, fuck. I can't believe it. Yeah, self-inflicted. You're right. I'm flipping the screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
They go play action now. Jackson.
He is swift. These guys ain't shading underneath the ball either. Dog! I tell y'all to play the flats! That's literally to the fucking flats! Come on, man. We're just getting eaten alive in the flats. I fucking knew it! I knew I should have been on the other hook! I knew it, bro! God, he runs the same plays! I know the fucking playbook! Oh my god, bro. That's tough. Get down and I gotta throw myself out of a hole. Can't stick to the game plan. Cause the run game's working. But you can't run the ball if you're down fucking three scores.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. I kind of feel like they've reached a do or die point in this game, Charles. If they're gonna try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here.
Najee's gonna get his.
You know, you don't want to have the quarterback dropping back 5 to 7 steps on every play.
and have the defense zero in on him. There you hope that you get your defense going one way. They sent him the other, and they picked up nice yardage with that completion. It's caught at the 10.
We know where that lower overall safety is there. I'm gonna come back for that. Okay, where's the formation? Yeah, I'm missing a formation. Why is it all the way over here now?
6 yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. Working out of the gun, it's Pickett. Being chased. And he's in.
Get a turnover here because we know he's going to go for his highlights and. Let him fuck around, make his highlights. Let's get a fucking stop here. We're going on conservative now. We've been running up too much.
Operating from the 27 now. Here, second and three. On the option to give the slip to him. Yeah, he'll get it up near the 35.
Who was that? Power reach. This is the part of the game where YK is just going to go through those,
work on that clock, see if you can continue to take it down.
Definitely, you want to leave things out at this point, right?
Continue. He's just going to go through all of his, read options. Yep, he's just going to go through all of his read options. Dog. I told y'all play the fuck over the top! Jesus Christ, man. Y'all don't fucking listen! What part of play over the top do y'all not get? Jesus Christ, man. Eighty-one. What you doing, dog?
Oh my gosh! Yeah, I went up to KT today. I told him, I was like, man.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Well, this game it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just haven't been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, that's a good way of putting things up because now it's not a total loss because, as you said, they scored some points and there's some points they can build on momentarily. The game plan actually works. They were just out personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
Fucking trailing me. But when my motherfucker's trailing, man, it's cooks.
something to go our
postseason.
Way.
Yeah, not the most creative or most inventive play call there, but not much has worked for them throughout this game. They're almost at a loss about what to dial up.
Now this one was tied in out on the right side. He's going to be taken down for the first down at the Ravens' 34-yard line.
First and 10 at the 34-yard line.
Throw it here. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line.
Down the keeper.
And they're going to speed things
the
up here.
At the 12-yard line. A 6-yard pickup. Brings up second and
Pickett
four.
Sets up play action.
If I threw that earlier, that's maybe a completion. But I got that ball out so fucking late. Because we can't cancel the play action.
But he has to be prepared for people making a play on it when that ball's up for grabs.
We gotta catch that! You finally get on the fucking field and what the fuck? You finally get on the field and you fumbled your chance, bro. This is why you got replaced.
They're going for it. This is Harris. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the area. No reason not to try it there. They do or not convert on fourth.
He was brought down at the 8-yard line. First and goal at the 8-yard line.
Scores down, three timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back.
Whoa! That's ours, that's ours, that's ours! Don't do this to me, EA! Y'all suck! That's ours, man. We all over it. He touched it first. Fucking terrible.
Get
a turnover here, please. No fumble. Oh, he shanked it. We're still in this.
This is first and 10.
turn to Harris to begin the drive. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's up 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
Looking to throw here. Pickett.
Whoa, I thought I spiked it. I'm a Puerto Rico, dog. Wow. That's crazy. That is crazy. Since fuck do I know?
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And three timeouts remaining here defensively, but really not much reason to use them at this point, as this one is all but over.
They use the timeouts here.
GG's. I told you that play before half would cost me the game. GG's.
So for Baltimore, the win will move into 7-2 now on the year. And they'll get another road date next week as their opponents will be the Tennessee Titans. Meanwhile, for the Steelers, they drop back to 500 now at 4 up and 4 down. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
I kind of agree with Peyton, but I still want to take those 3 shots on offense. All right, best plays that didn't count. Trav, I think this is officially his play from this last game. It's in the Hall of Ones. That's right. It's got to be up there with the greatest plays that technically never happened. He said to Josh Allen after the game, craziest one that will never count. Where does it rank among the best NFL plays that didn't count? We have Mahomes falling pass in the Super Bowl, Derrick Henry stiff arm and Josh Allen, Robert Hunt non-touchdown in the DeAndre Hopkins won him, right? I think this is about the Warriors winning the game. Especially for the context of what happened in the game.
I feel like there's going to be some other ones. These are all great plays, by the way. I remember the D-Hop one. Obviously, I think I was on the... might have been on the receiving end of Mahomes' falling pass. Either way, there I feel like there's some other ones that we're missing. So 92%ers, let us know if you got any Hall of Fames.
Highlights out. I knew that before halftime play cost me.
Best plays ever bracket.
I knew it did. You did a jersey swap. That's what I said right after it happened.
Dalton Kincaid.
The rook.
Who was very excited to get a Travis Kelce jersey. When Dalton was asked
I
about
knew
it,
said, it did.
That was pretty cool. I think
that's tough.
A little upset, but I'm pretty excited about it.
Man, Dawson is one of my favorite guys too.
Player, y'all suck.
Becoming, one of my favorite guys, man. Just to watch on film. I love watching.
And you have to actually accept these, or else it'll just apply it.
It's all the respect in the world to not only those guys, but all the tight ends around the league, man. And I think him saying Dawson was a little upset, he walked by and said, "How does the rook get a jersey before me?" And I kind of chuckled at it. So next time we play Dawson, you already know we got to swap it out, man.
Fans of bourbon and barbecue sauce, listen to this. Buffalo Wild Wings released a new limited time only sauce for football season, and you're never going to guess what it is. Jason, go ahead. Shoot me with some guesses. Hit me with.
Is it bourbon barbecue?
This can't happen.
Exactly what it was. Okay.
End of story.
How'd you know that, Jason?
Well, I know everything there is to know about B-dubs. But for the 90%ers out there who don't know, bourbon barbecue sauce is. And you gotta get there